They're getting ready. They're about to pick their teams.
Let's see. I think I feel the tension. I feel the tension.
Yeah.
They've set their mind. Yeah, we might be friends, but I'm taking away the trophy. I'm sorry.
A great amount of focus is required for those games.
Loads of focus. Let's see who they pick. I'm very interested.
All right.
Based on who they pick, I think I can predict what level of savagery they're going at. Are they going to pick someone in? Sasuke, I smelled it.
So
let's see. Let's see.
EMS Sasuke, which is the...
I like how they...
Wait.
Everyone's thinking Sasuke right now.
I think is actually not picking Sasuke.
Ooh.
Okay, so that was
interesting.
So basically what happened is that the first Sasuke that they picked is considered by many players probably the most powerful character in the game. Not the most broken, as some characters might be really tough to beat, right? But Sasuke has like the fastest melee in the game and he has a really powerful Temujutsu.
Was it Sanin Slayer who just picked one support?
No, Sanin Slayer won, where now it's Genji.
Oh, wait, my bad. Is it Genji who picked one support?
Well, I think it's Genji.
Genji? Or was it Genji? We're about to see anyway. I want to know. One support.
Yeah, but remember, the one support comes back much faster.
Interesting.
So we do not have the names of the players, but I believe that Urameshi is playing Obito right now, and Genji is playing Sasuke. Alright, so Obito's range in his combos are extremely, like, it's extremely long, right? So he has a great range here with his combos.
I'm yet to see someone use Obito really well because his combos knock you into weird places, in my experience, you know? So, I don't know what's gonna happen in terms of that.
Alright, also, something interesting to know, Obito's jutsu covers the full screen.
Yes.
So yeah, he can attack from afar and it's really fast. To be careful.
Really, yeah, the truth seeker all kind of thing.
Alright, so Genji's getting his subs back.
I wonder who's gonna take this. I mean, I would pick Sasuke any day over Obito. Obito is not one of my favorite, if I'm being honest. I really like this particular Obito.
But this Obito has really good combos. It's, you know, you might not look as cool as Sasuke, right? But it's pretty fast.
Yeah.
So usually people play those kind of characters to avoid having to dash. So they can just mash their buttons to try to
get their range.
Yeah.
I mean, I was going to say it means the same for Sasuke. Sasuke is speedy, less range, but speedy.
This Sasuke is... his range is not that good.
It's okay once he gets to the flame.
But remember, his air combo is probably one of the best in the game.
The air combo?
And his grab, you know, it's really good to catch the opponent off guard, precisely.
It actually looks like Obito's being able to...
Oh my god, is it a team? Oh my god, Pain!
That would have been beautiful,
defense.
But that was
perfect
a great
defense
as well.
Yeah, but he still has to be very careful, because whoever gets the next combo is...
Oh!
Yeah, that was the team
ultimate
of Sasuke.
That came out of nowhere. Nice!
So that ultimate for Sasuke protects him against everything. So you cannot be dashed at, it goes through most jutsus, and it's really, really powerful.
Ooh! They're dodging each other by, like, the skin of their teeth. It's crazy.
You trying to go for the Awakening?
We're going for the Awakening.
Okay, Awakening Susanoo.
Perfect Susanoo.
And he switched back.
He switched.
That's weird.
I think he's planning to throw with, dash fake out with Naruto and put pressure. Oh,
guard
he's
break.
Able to stop Nagato. Oh, this is getting to a close match. This is what I wanted. Let's see this. Oh, Pain
so
was able to...
So, attack switched after the tilt.
Nice.
Naruto, all right. Everyone's going to hack.
All right. They have to pace themselves.
That was
exactly
really good.
He
forced him to waste his sub, his last sub. And that might be it.
That was nice. He got him to get off that awakening, and now they are basically a little bit safer.
Oh, he failed once again.
No. He's going to take it.
So... Urameshi wasted both his guard break pills, while Genji used all his items but kept his guard break pills. So that's funny. And Urameshi takes it with Obito.
Nice. I don't know how I feel about Giant Awakenings. We've seen them work effectively so far. that Susanoo wasn't able to do as much as I think.
Because that's the thing. When you're awakening, you're gonna be extremely predictable. And if you're predictable, you're gonna die, because usually when you awaken, you're low on health. Sick grab. There was that's the thing. That grab is one of the fastest grabs in the game.
No.
And it lingers on the ground too, so it's very tricky. It's full of tricky frames.
You can land on it. You can walk into the back.
So remember, in this game, jumping with the block button on allows you to counterattack faster. So that's why a lot of players are jumping, as you can see.
Yeah.
But you have to remember that sometimes when you're landing, you're unable to block or sub. So that Sasuke ultimate right here could actually be, you know, be connecting. Even though, like, Uramichi would have his full subs or something.
Mm.
So he has to be careful not to jump guard too much.
Yeah. They have to really... I mean, I'm seeing a lot of cancels. A lot of really nice cancels.
Oh my god.
So the names have returned for you guys, keeping track, and we'll also be able to keep track.
So we have to apologize. There was a slight mix-up. So Uramichi is actually the one playing Sasuke.
Yep.
And Genji is the one playing Obito. We apologize. We were not provided with the players' names. So we got that mixed up. We're sorry.
Forgive us, please. All right. But you can tell in a way that they've really got their cancels down. I see a lot of double jump backflipping with
And you can see what they do is that they dash with one character and tech switch right away.
Yes.
Which is like, you know.
Ooh, yeah, the exactly grab,
it lingers.
Exactly,
he lingers.
It's a really tricky grab with tricky frames, yeah.
Okay, so Genji only has one sub left.
What? He didn't suspect that he was going to break the guard, I don't think.
So what's happening is that if you use a guard break peel item while the opponent is already in a guard break, you will push back the opponent instead of freezing him again.
Oh, nice. Oh, nice. Oh, I bet he was hoping to cancel out the support with a switch, or at least miss it.
All
looks
right.
Like Genji might be
complicated.
Position.
Wait, Uramichi is getting a bit overconfident. He has two subs left.
Don't let it turn
anything
out like
can
a
happen
combat.
Depending. Oh my god. He has to be extremely careful now.
Ooh,
and he takes it.
He takes it. He takes it. Jutsus are kind of safe, especially when the projectiles and you have enough distance.
So this Sasuke with that fireball can use his jutsu in the air. So he waited, you know, in the air blocking to wait for him to dash at him, and he used the jutsu.
Yeah.
So that was a sick counterattack.
That.
This Sasuke is probably one of the best characters in the game to play in the air, if I may say. His aerial game is one of the best.
Look at the nerves! Look at the tension! Like, it's close. You can tell. They practice. This is what happens. And they're trying to bring their A game. And it's crazy. You can see a lot of stylish players. Stylish players, pretty much, with the European kind of people who play the game. So, it's always beautiful to see. When people are able to make the game look nice with their little strategies and tactics.
Yeah, exactly.
As lock down the damage.
It might be a bit hard to understand everything that's going on if you're not familiar with the game. But basically, they are all using mind games. They're trying to pretend that they're going to be dashing at the opponents, and then they're going to track switch, which means it's only their supports that know is dashing to the opponent. And this is very confusing. It's meant to confuse the opponent. So
it's like Slay said earlier, it's a game that basically it's got one execution button, but so many.
Yeah, the timing, the different movesets, because even though all the characters, you have different types of characters, obviously, but let's say all the characters will use the circle button to attack, you know, to pull off special moves and stuff like this, they will pull the moves the same way. The animations, the hitboxes, you know, everything is going to be different, the recovery times. So the execution is easy. It's meant to be easy, right?
Yeah, it's meant to be easy because can you imagine if it wasn't on top of all the things that you can do in this game? It'd be like, whoa.
But it doesn't prevent the game from having tons of mind games and pressure, and it's very, very fun to see.
Oh, it looks like Uramichi has finalized on Toby. Hmm. We've seen Hashirama play in this championship so far, but Toby?
Yeah.
One support still. Interesting.
Uramichi is playing a really fair team. I would say is like just looking at those teams, I would say the advantage is definitely for Genji right now.
Yeah.
He is one of the best team in the game. He has Sage Hashirama with the really powerful jutsu that we've seen in the first matches. He has EMS Sasuke
that you can switch to.
Was easily top three in the game characters, and he has Naruto with, as we said, the aerial support. Naruto is.
Sasuke isn't so useful, in my opinion, as an aerial support, but obviously as a character that you can switch to in this game.
Yeah.
Let's see how it turns out, though. Genji is losing at the beginning.
Exactly. If Ramesh takes this, he is definitely
Did you just see that? He faked out with a dash so that Madara could take the brunt of the fireball.
Yep.
Which didn't affect his health because he had already switched.
Exactly.
Ooh, that counter. I haven't seen that in a while. That was a tilt from Madara.
So he canceled his recovery time by switching out with Toby.
Pretty much. Pretty.
All right, so now he's going to do massive damage.
Ooh. I don't know if he wanted to sub that guard break thing.
So remember, once you're out of subs, they will come back, all four of them, after a certain amount of time. So it's best sometimes to just take the damage, right? And to wait for all your subs to come back. This Susanoo is not as strong as the other Susanoo that we've seen so far. But who knows?
I haven't been able to... He missed...
Okay, so Obito's tilt. If you're familiar with the manga, Obito is using his powers as Mangekyo Sharingan, right? He's being untouchable for
a few seconds. But it does leave you very vulnerable.
Yeah, if you fail, you're going to be vulnerable.
Struggling to use the Susanoo, but once he's got off the damage, it might help. Oh, he wasn't able to do much with it. But it is one of the best ways to utilize damage, though. I mean...
You gotta do what you gotta do. There's loads of stakes. Loads at stake.
So now, yep, he's using EMS Sasuke, going for the strongest combos in the game. Ramesh is down two subs.
Ooh.
Sick tilt. So Madara's tilt allows him to repel people like this, right?
Ooh.
So he pushes them away.
And the Mangekyo Sharingan Tobi just allowed Naruto to go right through him. Oh,
so Genji
has
his subs
back.
And he's going to break the guard. Oh, wow.
Oh, wow.
It does damage. I didn't know it did.
Interesting. I mean, I knew it did, but I didn't think he was able to pull it off in that short frame in between the combos.
That is...
And that's a lot of health. That's a lot of health ahead. I didn't
You have to remember that he had awakened, so he took double damage.
You're right.
That's why he got killed.
You're right. Is it when he de-awakened, he was taking on more damage?
Yeah, when you de-awaken, after your awakening time is over, you have a debuff that basically makes you weaker, both in terms of attacks and defense. Also, remember, one thing interesting is that in this game, when your clothes are destroyed, it's not just cosmetic. You actually have less defense when they break.
Really?
Yeah.
Never knew that. I thought it was cosmetic.
Yeah. If you were to play another character that would have his full costume on, it would take less damage.
Ooh. This, wow,
oh my
that's
God.
One thing about awakening people. When you awaken, ultimate juice should just seem to just get you easily because, you know, you move slower, so you take longer to guard and cancel into a guard or even know that it's coming to hit you.
Oh my
so
God.
Big.
And he has the awakening debuff too, so... It's probably a bit raging for Ramesh to have, you know, lost so many health points because he had four subs, so he could have dodged that.
Yeah. Taken over, but then it does allow Genji to get a comeback.
Yeah, definitely.
But I don't think Arameshi is going to give it to him so easily.
So they're both trying to spam their special abilities from afar because they both don't want to take risks anymore. Oh my God!
Oh,
yep.
Oh, nice.
Naruto's tracking is so good, right? He really keeps the opponent on plays. He cannot move at all while Naruto is targeting him.
I'm kind of surprised that Genji isn't taking most of the match. Taking over
with that team?
Yeah.
Well, that being said, ever since he switched back to Sasuke, he's doing much better. surprisingly.
Surprisingly, in quotes.
With probably top three best character in the game. Surprisingly, he's doing much better.
Ooh. Yeah. See, Madara tried to pull off that thing,
that tilt again,
but
that did not
so
work.
Damn fast. Oh, you might have a problem if you can't use that.
Oh, great counter.
Nice.
He was whiffing his combos, and he expected Urameshi to dash at him, so he used a counter. That was really good. Okay, it's going to be extremely dangerous for Urameshi. Oh my God, it's going to take a lot of damage.
Nice.
So remember, guys,
pause.
It's best sometimes not to sub, so that you wait until your subs come back. Otherwise, you're going to be, you know, left with no subs all the time. So that's why sometimes players decide to take the damage anyway. Oh my God, and I believe Genji's going to take this. So right now, Genji doesn't have enough chakra to dash at a run machine. No, he does. But basically, when you're in a combo, if you want to dash at a character, either to make your combo longer or just to simply, you know, dash at the opponent that's trying to run away from you, you need more chakra.
Exactly. Let's see how this goes, though, because Genji, like we predicted...
Great counter! That was an amazing counter! And his guard is actually red, so... Oh my god, Urameshi, sick action. Sick action.
He was able to get Madara.
It's extremely close. It is extremely close.
This is what I like. Close matches. How are we going to do this? How is this going to turn out? Two friends... Play it out.
He could have,
countering, people getting nervous, trying to anticipate each other's sub.
Oh my god, a grab.
Finish it? I don't think so. But it's gonna leave this tense. So and Genji has 1%. This is intense.
Oh, cheap damage. And Urameshi takes it.